Swear the testimony you're about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, to help you God.
I do.
Sit right down there, Mr. Chambers, and talk in the microphone.
That's the one, yes.
Your full name?
For the record.
My full name is J. David Whittaker Chambers. Philadelphia, in 1901, April 1st.
What is your present occupation?
I am a senior editor of Time magazine.
Were you at one time a member of the Communist Party?
I was.
How long were you a member of the Communist Party?
I was a member of the Communist Party from 1924 until 1937 or 38.
You detailed to the committee the various positions which you held in the Communist Party.
Yes. I was at one time a writer on the Daily Worker, later a foreign news editor of the Daily Worker, later, in effect, managing editor of the Daily Worker, editor of the New Masses, and a functionary in the underground.
Mr. Chambers, when you were with the New...
32, roughly through 1937.
During that period, did you meet the person who was on the witness stand today, Alger Hiss?
I did meet Mr. Alger Hiss.
Would you now give to the committee a chronological resume of your meeting of Mr. Hiss and how long you knew Mr. Hiss, the circumstances under which you met him?
I believe that I was first introduced to Mr. Hiss by Harold Ware and Jay Peters, who was the head of the underground of the American Communist Party. The meeting took place in Washington, and I believe in a restaurant. I then continued to know Mr. Hiss until I broke with the Communist Party in early 1938, and I saw him once again toward the end of 1938.
Did you ever meet Mr. Hiss at the offices of the Nye Investigating Committee?
Never,
in the Senate office building?
I never did.
You never did? Did you ever meet Mr. Hiss at his apartment on 28th Street?
I did.
How many times did you meet Mr. Hiss, would you say, at the address on 28th Street?
I could not.
You did not. Did Mr. Hiss ever sublease an apartment to you on 28th Street?
He did not.
He did not. Did he ever permit you to live in an apartment on 28th Street?
He did.
He did. Did Mr. Hiss at any time sell you the Ford automobile Model A 1929 model?
He did not.
He did not. Do you have a question, Mr. Did you?
The was in the whole setup. Jay Peters was the organizer of the underground section of the Communist Party. He was dealing with party comrades, and these were dues-paying members of the Communist Party.
Jay Peters introduced Alger Hiss to you as a member of the Communist Party.
That was understood.
Do you have any other information on what you
Mr. Hiss obeyed party discipline in every respect.
Did you yourself have occasion at any time to pay dues to Mr. Hiss?
I did.
On one occasion or more occasions?
At least on one occasion, and I would think on at least on three occasions.
Have there been more or less than that? Do you know what kind of automobile Mr. Hiss had?
The first car, the car Mr. Hiss had when I first knew him was a Ford.
What did he get after that?
A Plymouth.
You ever ridden in that Plymouth?
I have.
You ever ridden right?
I think we made one trip to New York together in the Plymouth. We made a trip. Organization of the underground. There should be no communication between the open Communist Party and the underground Communist Party except through people delegated by either of those sections. Mr. Hiss, however, insisted that his old car should be given to the Open Communist Party to be used by some poor communist organizer in the West or elsewhere. I was very much opposed to this. J. Peter was also very much opposed to it. But, however, I will tell my address and get rid of this question right away.
No, I don't think so, Mr. Chairman.
None at all.
Well, give your business address.
My business address is...